now I want to talk about the background of the project. Breton Nilai Transportation Hub are going to relocate the bus station in the Nilai and using 1.5 million to improve the transport infrastructure, and it will start in the May 1st, 2016 and complete in 1st May 2018. And the new bus station will locate at the area which near to railway, and this new bus station will refer to the Bandar Tasik Selatan to be our design and construct in the concept of green building, so it can increase the energy efficient and environment friendly. In new bus station, it will construct in 3 level, and the ground floor is the area for waiting bus, and the first floor is for ticket selling, and the second floor will be the food court and entertainment venue.
Now we are going to introduce about the identify key element. This included the green building technology, bridge, steel structure, railway, and subsoil drainage. First of all, I'm going to introduce about the green building technology. Green building technology also means that sustainable building, means that building is designed, constructed, renovated, reused in a natural asset proficient way. So the new bus terminal is designed with energy efficiency technology by introducing the landlight strategy and water savings. The first element to be introduced is grazing panel. This picture has shown that the grazing panel has been used in the facade of the TBS. So this concept is going to apply in the new bus terminal, as this allows landlight penetrate into the building, which means meet the requirement of energy efficiency. Laminate glass is used to prevent breakage and stone breakage, as this type of glass prevents shatter when it is broken. And it's also brought a part of laminate and control the amount of laminate to be penetrated into the building. Next will be the roof shading and the sky with skylight. Roof shading with skylight act as a passive solar heating sources. The multiple layer of glazing can be with inner glazes such as argon in between their layers, or it can be covered with low emissivity film to reduce the heat loss, wave variation, and solar energy gain. For the evolution for integrated with laylight, grazing panel and roof shelving with skylight allow light penetrate into the building. It is very suitable to be used for a large building like new bus terminal. According to Sharifa Fairo, she said that the laylight bring a lot of benefit. Firstly, it is free and environment friendly. Besides that, it matches the human vision, responds in non-fatigue. And compared to the artificial lighting, it consumes less electricity and energy. Then, the laylight from the roof provides an evenly distribution of light, and it's really suitable as ambient lighting is needed over a large region with minimal shadow. The next element to be introduced is bridge. Bridge acts as a transportation connection of pedestrians between the new built bus terminal and the existing rail station. The Children Bridge is the truss bridge. For the truss bridge, the look of the entire bridge is supported by the truss. Truss is very rigid. It transfers the load from a single point to more wider area. For the evaluation of the truss bridge, truss bridge gives convenience to the pedestrian or user of bus terminal and rail station. Truss bridge has been chosen because it's very strong, because of the unique triangle design provides support for form bridge, and the construction cost is relatively low. The material required to construct is minimal, and every single bar is used effectively. It's because the strength comes when the material are formed to triangle shape. Besides that, there are also some disadvantages about the truss bridge. The design and construction process involved is very complicated, and the triangle should be in perfect size and amount to ensure the safeness. And this requires more space in building, as this also requires additional support in the construction process. That's all for my presentation. Thank you.
Now I would like to present the key element analysis and evaluate of the steel structure. Okay, steel structure can be divided into many types. First is steel frame. Okay, it provides low, wide and high strength properties, and it can reduce the load which should be carried. And steel frame commonly used in a factory and storage because it can provide large aerial support. Next, there are several types of steel frame. First is Thai portal frame. This type of frame can reduce the bending movement which is in the column and horizontal movement of the edge. And this type of frame useful in limit the spread which is in the crane and supporting structure. Second type of steel frame is proper portal frame. It can reduce the dimension of rafter and horizontal shelf which is at the foundation. And the third is cellular beam portal frame. This type of frame, it rafter which are produced using cellular beam are for stylish reason and giving the purpose of long traverses where transport confinement force necessary for joint, the ought to be deliberately itemized to protect the composition element. Now is analysis and evaluate of steel frame. In our new bus station, we will use a proper portal frame because it ability to create large span space and lightweight, so it normally used in the high-rise building and it can reduce the cost of the project. And the advantages of steel structure are it can make the project complete quickly because most of the work are done in the factory. Next, steel structure are very flexible because steel structure are good in resist force of dynamic such as wind load and earthquake force. Besides, steel structure provide wide range of the method which joining steel structure members such as welding, bolting, and riveting. The advantages of steel structure is which is they will be corrosion if do not have the good protection, and it also will lose strength when the temperature is high, which due to the expansion of steel. Next is steel roof trusses. Steel roof trusses are stronger material than timber, so it has the function of fire resistant and normally in triangle plan frame. External force which applied on the framework are normally applied at the joints. And the force which occur on the truss are tension and compression. Steel structure are used in building which are long span, and the function of trusses are normally carry heavy load and transfer the load from the structure. And the type of steel structure got several types. First is park truss. This type of truss suitable for the building which existing 20 to 100 meters in span. And standing member of this type of truss are normally in the tension force for gravity load. And the park truss with an alternative is with the diagram member are in the force of tension for uplift load, and this truss used on which uplift load are predominant. The second type of trusses are varan truss. This type of truss suitable for the building which existing 20 to 100 meters. And diagonal member are in the force of tension and in compression. This type of truss commonly used in the horizontal truss of gantry or crane builder. Next, length of compression and tension web member are equally. Next is north lighting truss. This type of truss suitable for the building which are short span, and in this type of truss increase natural light and reduce the operation carbon emission by the use of glazing, and it normally faces to the direction of the north or northeast to reduce gain of the solar energy. Next is sawtooth truss. This type of truss similar to north light truss, and it includes a vertical face running perpendicular to the plan of sawtooth truss. And this type of truss suitable for the multi bay building. And the last is fin truss. this type of truss suitable for the short span roof, and the member of this type of truss are submitted into shorter element. Economy, it also is a economy trusses for the roof of building. And the internal member of fin truss such as group and type can arrange in many ways with according to the requirement of the edge. Okay, fin truss is normally used to construct roof of the house. Now I would like to talk about the analysis and evaluate of the trusses. Even in our new bus station, we are using wear truss, and the advantages of this type of truss are it have an equal length of compression and tension. Therefore, it can spread the load equally. Besides, this type of truss can avoid member of different length, so the truss can be easily constructed in the factory, and it will reduce the cost of the project. And this type of truss, in the large span of the modified boring truss, the addition restraint must be adopted to the truss because this can reduce the secondary trusses. The advantages of boring truss is it have a poor performance under the concentrated load, and when the structure is experiencing a traversal load, the truss structure will experience concentrated force under a point load. Last, under this concentrated burden situation, the structure is not as great as is producing the load uniformly over each individuals.
In our project, we have 5 elements, but I only present 1 key element and the analysis and evaluation for that element. For my part is railway. First and foremost, I will present function of railway. Railway are considered as one of the safety transport system or land when constructed with different type of transport. Railway has formed a brand and new method and way for transportation with up to the unknown capacity, speed and reliability. In terms of capacity, railway provided a continuous and unchanging hard solid surface for the train to transport large amount of passenger and cargoes. In terms of reliability and stability, both of passenger and cargoes can be safely transported another destination within time given, and the risk is very low. And the final one is speed. Railway allow train travel in a high speed but using an integrated system of specialized rolling stock and this dedicated tracks. The general range for the rail for the train of travel speed is approximately 250 km per hour for new lines and existing lines in excess of 200 km per hour. For railway, they are consist of 6 components, which are ballast, railway rails, sleeper, fastening, sub ballast, and subframe. For the first component, railway, and 2 fundamental types of rail currently manufactured, which are freight bottom rail and bullhead rail. Both of these are manufactured by wrought iron, and for the bullhead rail has a heavy weight on top, implying that if left to remain solidly, it will fall down. And for the freight bottom rail has a freight base beneath it, thus it sits on the floor without falling over. For the second component is sleeper. The function of sleeper is hold rails in right alignment and spacing and to support and distribute the weight. The second function is transmit the longitudinal and lateral forces from the train to ballast and keep the gauge and backing the rails themselves. The third component is ballast. Ballast is the foundation of railway track and comprised of root or broken stone that are under the rail or sleeper. The function of ballast is transfer and distribute the load from sleeper to a wider area. The second function for the ballast is resistant to the trait to longitudinal horizontal stability, and the final one is provide effective drainage to trait. Besides that, fastening are assemble the trait to the stipper and reels together and so on. The types of fastening are numerous, which have been utilized on the railroad. Most common types of fastening is fish rack, ventral crimp, elastic spike, and others. For the sub-ballast is comprised of root, rock, sand, or soot, and it is mercury compared to the ballast. The function of sub-ballast is give a level surface to the ballast and other trade parts. It is spread about a large portion of the profundity of the aggregate counterbalance segment. For the final components is half. The final component is subgrade. Subgrade act as a natural layer which are happening material the road is built upon, and also allude to the important fill material that has been utilized to make an embankment upon when the pavement is developed. The quality of the subgrade is measured by CBR test, and the thickness of the road pavement can be affected by the quality of the subgrade. For the analysis and evaluation of railway, there are two types of railway track currently in use in this civilization, which are ballasted railway and ballast railway. Both of them contain their own advantages and disadvantages. For the type of railway, we could like to suggest to build parallel railway track in the new terminal bus station, as the reason will compare the below. The first type is ballasted railway track. Ballasted railway is comprised generally of rail laid on wooden or solid sleeper, bolstered by a ballast bag. The advantages of ballasted railway is such as high maintainability at relatively low expenses, because the cost for the maintenance fee is quite low, because only need to employ worker to clean the ballast railway. The second advantage is high degree of sound absorption. Therefore, the problem about nuisance to the surrounding area of the station can be reduced and minimized. For the disadvantages of ballasted railway, is require periodic maintenance. Ballasted railway track need maintained within the range of 0.5 years to 6 years, and it will chill up at high speed when the track is passing over the railway, which might harm to rails and wheels. And also, the ballasted railway track is heavyweight and construction cost is quite higher compared to others. The second type is parallel railway track. Parallel railway track basically is used to alternate the ballasted railway track, as it is used to minimize the weakness of the ballasted railway track. For the parallel railway track, only contain three advantages and no disadvantages. The advantages for ballasted railway track is stable, precise, and rut conform. And second advantages is long life cycle and maintenance required is very low. And final one is empowers more straightforward steering of train lines with more tightly rated and more prominent inclines. That's all for my part. Thank you.
Hello, good morning to our lecturer and all my friends. Now, I will continue to explain the drainage system that we will apply to our new bus station. So, first of all, what is drainage system? Drainage system actually is a system that used to discharge or dispose to the water and send to the treatment plant or release them to the stream. Besides that, it also has another one function that is used for agriculture. So, this is TBS Terminal Bus Data. This bus station. This terminal, we are going to look into the drainage design because its design is very good. So we will apply some of the design to our new station bus So first of all, before we start, I would like to explain the three effluents that are found in our country. In our country, Malaysia, we have three types of effluent. The first effluent is the surface water. Surface water also can be called as slow water because it's clean and can be directly discharged to the stream. The second one is subsoil water. Subsoil water is found under the ground. So the third one is soil and waste water. This kind of water consists of human fecal. This gives a meaning that it has a microorganism, harmful substances, so it cannot be directly discharged to the stream. It might listen to the treatment plant. So, appliances to discharge surface water. Before I start, our normal appliances to discharge surface water will be roof, rainwater pipe, and the gutter. So, besides these appliances, I would like to add on one more appliances that found on the TPS. That is this one. Soap water inlet. This soap water inlet is used to discharge the water, the soap water on the ground floor and to the certain pipe. So, what's the reason for using this construction? First, it is high durability because the precast concrete used to build the construction is very hard. So it's nearly 25 or above east. So this pipe, so it impact the construction is very durability. The second one, shorter construction duration because it is a precast concrete. So the factory just send the construction here and then we just install it. So it very fast. Next, so we talk to the next appliance to discharge the subsoil water. So as you can see, this is our typical subsoil image. So initially, this is a concept that we use a fine sand at the top here to allow the water to be absorbed to the pipe, and there will be a pipe here, and then the pipe will discharge the groundwater or subsoil water to other places. So this is a hills, as you can see from here. This is a bank of building, as I said just now, the fine upgrade. And then the behind one is the normal sand. So the water will flow through and then they will be absorbed to here. So this will be a membrane. The membrane will be act as a filter to prevent the big substances such as lava to be stuck in the pipe. So what is this pipe? This pipe can be called as porous or perforated subsoil pipe. This pipe actually is content of multi mini hole. So this hole will actually allow the water to flow into the pipe and then discharge the water away. So this is a solution that I would like to suggest this installed in our new bus station. This is because this design is part of TBS. This is called subsoil drainage outlet. This outlet actually has a lot of function. The first function is it has really good appearances, okay, because it's, as you can see, it's really nice looking, black and white, computing. And then the second one is very important because it can reduce the erosion rate. How is reduce the erosion rate? Because when we discharge the water, the velocity is very high. Can you see the landing slab here? The landing slab actually can slow down the velocity so that the impact to the sand will be low. So the it leads to our result to reduce in erosion rate. So now we will discuss the last one. This is the appliances to discharge soil and wastewater. So before we go, because stormwater and surface water is from outside, so how from the water from inside? So actually we need a system that we design and we according to the TPS, because TPS is using single pass system. This system is a good system that can be applied to our new station bus. So why this system single pipe system? Actually, this single pipe system, it consists of a main pipe, and on the top of the loop there will be a waypoint. So this kind of system is used to discharge the wastewater and the bulk and wastewater inside the building to outside of the building. So what is the advantage? Because it's allowed before gases to be released to the top of the building. As I said just now, there will be a vent point at the top of the building. So this vent point actually will release the four gases, so the four gases will not be trapped inside the pipe. So the second one is news runs in negative pressure. So, because actually sometimes the human will create a negative pressure to the bike. So, actually, this single wing bike also has a wing coil. The wing coil actually can neutralize it so that actually, so that can reduce the prevention effect flow of the water.
Next.
So actually, for the three top improvements, surface water, substrate water, flow and waste water, actually they all will be flowed into the main hole. Main hole is a place that will gather all the water and then discharge to the outlet, either outlet, streams or the treatment plant. So in these cases, we are using this manhole and then using also precast manhole. This is because this precast manhole also allows the construction fast and then it's durability.
Okay, next.
So this is a system that we designed to discharge the surface water and the combined water, which is combined water with surface water and the flow and waste water. So as you can see, the rainwater down here, they will be connected to only surface water sewer. But the back inlet will be for sink based at the ground floor level, which is the bonus. So I went by here, they will discharge the water to the combined water sewer. We also there is a rainwater down here, they also connect together and then discharge to combined water sewer. This is because it can prevent not only Okay, so this will be partially separate system. So this will partially separate system that we design to discharge the combined water and the only surface water. As you can see from here, the rainwater turbine here actually only combined to the surface water. And then the rainwater turbine and the soil and turbine here, they actually connect together and then connect to combined water sewer and send to treatment plant. Okay, so why will we do this? So why is it we using pathway surface system? First, it is reducing construction costs. This is in terms of the piping, the size, the length, and also reducing number of manhole can save a lot of money. So second, allow easy maintenance, because some of the surface water, it does not consist of bits of water, actually will causing sucking. So maintenance will be easy to be done. And then for the flow and waste water, the manhole will be bigger size. So in bigger size, maintenance will be easy to be done. So the third one, implementation of harmful substance breakfall. Yeah, this is because when some water or because of waste water is too much, so they will be sometimes they will breakfall. So after we separate the flow water and surface water, when there is a back flow of the water, there is no harmful substance that will harm our human health. So, what's the next is analysis and evaluation. So, some of the material that EPS use, I think is not suitable to be used in our new station. So, we're going to change something. First, the material, because the EPS material using rainwater one is using cast iron. So we suggested that the rainwater one used for our new station is using PVC. So, what's the reason? Because nowadays, technology is very advanced, so PVC pipe already has the same function similar to the cast iron. Besides that, PVC no need to be applied an oil to prevent it erosion, so it's also high in terms of cost saving. So, second one, the material of sanitary appliances in the DPS is using ceramic. So we think that ceramic is not suitable because it's expensive. So we decide to change to Richard's China. Richard's China, although its quality is quite low of it, but it's already good enough for us to use in the bus station. So that's all. So, next. So as a conclusion, our new station is also can be considered as a green building. So green building not only do protection. So nowadays, the technology of film reading is getting more and more advanced. So we hope, so actually we want to say thank you to our lecturer, and we hope that our research will help us to gain knowledge, not only knowledge and also the experiences that will help us in the future. Thank you.